Hello everyone, and welcome back to the BodyMetrix Pro training tutorials. We'll discuss how to perform and interpret a 2D waist scan of the abdomen, along with some other options within the scan tab. Let's briefly review a waist measurement first to give you some background knowledge that will help you with understanding the different layers of adipose tissue. Remember from our previous tutorials that the ultrasound signal spikes or characteristic peaks identify boundaries or interfaces between different tissue types. In this waist measurement, the individual has a total fat thickness of 17.4 millimeters, representing subcutaneous fat. Subcutaneous fat in the abdomen can then be broken down into two compartments or layers. Superficial adipose tissue, or SAT, is the first layer from 0 millimeters to this first strong peak at approximately 9 millimeters. This peak actually represents a thin layer of connective tissue known as a fascia, separating the superficial and deep adipose tissue layers. The deep adipose tissue, or DAT, is a layer between the fascia and the actual fat muscle interface here at 17.4 millimeters. Now, with elite individuals, the superficial and deep layers tend to merge together and form one layer. However, as people become more sedentary due to poor diet or lack of exercise, the fat then separates into these two distinctive layers. With the scan feature, we can actually see these layers and quantify them as we'll demonstrate next. Click on the scan tab, and from the scan point drop-down menu, select the waist. Next, adjust the intensity level to 160, as this helps reduce the number of white regions seen, which can be an indication of a saturated signal, especially on more sedentary or obese individuals. The default value of 180 should be suitable for relatively fit individuals. Next, you'll apply a quarter-sized amount of gel to the head of the BodyMetrix device as shown. Beginning 1 inch to the right of the umbilicus, spread the gel approximately 3 to 4 inches horizontally towards the right side without pressing the button as shown. You're moving the device back and forth to ensure it glides smoothly on the skin without binding or sticking. When you're ready to start the scan, go back to your starting point 1 inch to the right of the belly button, press the button on the BodyMetrix device, and slowly drag the device in a smooth fluid motion 3 to 4 inches towards the right side of the body, making sure that the device is flush and perpendicular on the skin. This should take approximately 4 to 5 seconds. The left side of the image represents the start of the scan, essentially the same place you would take a waist measurement when calculating body fat percentage, 1 inch to the right of the umbilicus. The right side depicts the end of the scan, 3 or 4 inches away from the sight point. The first consistent white band of signal represents the fascia separating the superficial and deep adipose layers. The second, thicker band of white signal is the actual fat muscle interface. Note that if we drag a small rectangle from the center of this fat muscle interface to the top of the image, the total fat thickness or subcutaneous fat is measured automatically and displayed here. Note that this coincides with the original sight point measurement we took earlier at 17.4 millimeters. One important thing to note here is that the depth scale for measuring sight points only goes to a maximum of 60 millimeters. It's possible that extremely sedentary or obese clients potentially exceed 60 millimeters and that the actual fat muscle interface signal cannot be seen. The solution is to perform a waist scan because the depth can be adjusted to capture the tissue and the scan measurement can then be transferred to the measure point in the formula as we'll demonstrate now. Again, if we drag a rectangle from the center of the fat muscle interface to the top of the image, total fat thickness is displayed along with a two measure button. Clicking on this button brings up a window where you're asked if you would like to transfer the measurement to the waist point. Select yes, and if we navigate back to the measure tab, you can see that the measurement was transferred. The scan feature gives you the option of transferring scan measurements to any point within your body composition formula if you like. Scans offer definitive proof, much like an X-ray image, so if there's ever any doubts with regards to measuring site points, image scans can be done as a means of verification if necessary, or if the fat muscle interface is beyond 60 millimeters when taking a site point measurement on obese individuals. We can also track the various interfaces and quantify both the superficial as well as the deep adipose tissue layers. Click on the Track Interface button and place your cursor in the center of the fascia signal as shown, and then click. You can adjust the tracking by setting your own data points by moving your cursor to the desired area and then clicking again to adjust it. Once you're satisfied with the tracking, click the Stop Tracking button. We have now quantified the superficial adipose tissue layer from the top of the image to the fascia. Next, let's track the actual fat muscle interface signal here at 17 millimeters and adjust it as needed. We'll click the Track Interface button first and go directly to that second band and then click. Again, when you're satisfied with the tracking, click the Stop Tracking button. The layer between the two red tracking markers represents deep adipose tissue, or DAT. Deep adipose tissue is virtually identical to visceral fat in terms of insulin resistance, reflecting elevated risk levels for diabetes, heart disease, and stroke. At the end of the day, any amount of DAT is potentially dangerous, and the ability to show changes in these layers helps clients understand the value of these scans as it relates to their health and wellness. Notice that we see a third white interface signal band here around 30 millimeters, which represents the end of the rectus abdominis muscle. You can track that as well to quantify muscle thickness, as we'll do in this instance. Below this last red tracking marker is the abdominal cavity. You can save the image by selecting the Save Image button and compare changes in adipose layers by selecting the Compare Images button. You'll be prompted to save the changes, so be sure to select Yes. From the drop-down menu on the left, you can select the waist scan point and then select the date and time of the image that you're interested in, possibly an initial baseline image of your client's waist. On the right side, select the waist point and the date and time of the scan image you want to compare it with. In this example, it's evident that both adipose tissue layers have been reduced, and more importantly, the deep adipose layer, or DAT, which again correlates highly with elevated risk levels for diabetes, heart disease, and stroke. Selecting the Print Report button at the top left of the screen gives you the options to print the report, save it to a file, or email it directly to your client. Selecting the X at the bottom left of the screen gives you the ability to delete images from the gallery if you wish. You can do this by selecting Yes or No. In the next tutorial, we'll discuss the My Health tab and the reporting features of the BodyMetrix system. Thank you.